Right, guys, so as I promised, I'll take you through every step of the way. So first job, and it's so cold, it's minus one at the moment. First job is to move that sort of little like child's playhouse, and then we're gonna build it the full width. Now I'll just try and put the sun on my hands. So that pad's gonna be the shed. Sorry, I'm just trying to block shed out. Sun out. That's gonna be the shed, and then we're gonna go, if you can just make it out, there's a faint black line all the way up there, and then that's that there, from the edge of there all the way to the front. That'll be 14 foot front to back and 7 foot for the wrap room. And then from the edge of that building all the way down to the shed is about 28 feet for urban. So if I stand here soon, obviously I would be stood inside of urban, and it still gives a ton of space for my kids to play and things like that. So guys, this is step number one. Stand right back. You can't get a sense of feel on camera. Now, if you're wondering what the bricks are, these were just to get a level from that point to that point to that point to that point. Someone's actually taken a brick off of that one. So we're gonna have to dig this down and level it out, and then dig for the sort of footings. So yeah, guys, this is step number one. Wish as well, and I'll film as much as I possibly can, but without making it too boring. So cheers, guys, bye. Phase one done. So now we have to dig this bit down, because this is considerably higher than that. So we're gonna kind of level this out to some degree, then dig down for the footings. We just gotta get all this dirt moved. So that's step one done. It was a bit of a nightmare to move that, but we got it out.
You can't contain me with chains, I'm free and I run free. Any enemy is coming with me when I'm done. Whatever's asked of me, I perform. I rip through the rain into the eye of the storm. Still carrying the flame, I have a torch. Failure comes at a price I can't afford. Never been half-hearted, I put my all in. Forfeited all just to answer my calling. Wearing the scars of the wars that I fought in. Should have been heading for the stars, but I'm falling.
Right, guys, so this is day number two. As you can see there's the roof of the kids' playhouse. There's a door and what was inside the playhouse. Now, there's the walls of the playhouse and the frame, the floor frame, what was dug around 15, 16 inches deep. You can see there just how deep it went. It was really difficult to get out. As you may have seen on some of the time lapses, I'm just gonna try and block that sun out. This section had that weed barrier, which was a nightmare to get up. So you can see that faint black line. Urban's gonna, the level's taken from there to there and upwards. So we've got a ton of dirt, and I don't mean one ton, I mean several tons of dirt still to move. Gotta dig up all this mud. And if you're wondering why we didn't use a mini digger and skips to get rid of the soil, is because there's no road access to this garden from the road. So it would have meant I would have had to hire a crane to lift everything in, and then hire a crane to lift it all back out. Something I wasn't prepared to do. I don't mind doing the manual labor, basically. So we shifted a lot of the dirt to there, to here, and then over there, and then a load of it, you can't really tell, but it's all down there. So I'm just distributing it as and where I can, just to get rid. So yeah, so we'll carry on. Got a lot of digging to do. Ben's on his way. You may have noticed I was wearing trainers yesterday. That's because I couldn't find my work boots, so my wife's gone to go buy me a new pair of work boots. So that'll be good. Be a lot better to work in work boots and trainers on this sort of ground. So yeah, steady way we're going at it, and yeah, it should be good. So one thing I should really touch base on is, you may notice that this section right at the top is higher up. Now we have two options. We either shift all that and try and find somewhere to put it all, or we make urban start, sorry about the camera guys, urban start here, and then we'll put all damp across there, and then that'll be the rat barn. So it will be smaller in size, it look legit on the outside, but it will be smaller internally. That doesn't really matter to me. Urban's the main building, and that's the part that needs to be spacious, because that's the part I'm going to spend the most time in. So that'll be around 7 feet in height, urban will be 8 feet. So we have two options, either make it 7 feet or and move all this, or sacrifice 1 foot inside, which won't really matter. I'm 5'10", a 7 foot building inside will be high enough for me. So we made the decision to leave that a little bit higher, ground level. So we'll move all this dirt. I won't film it, it'll be boring, but we'll move all this dirt, and then we'll start sinking the blocks in, and then it'll be kind of the fun part. So wish us well, guys. Cheers. You're laughing at it, twat. Hey guys, so this is day three. Now, unfortunately, it's got incredibly cold here. It's currently -2, you can see all frost on the ground. So now, you can hear the frost underfoot. So now all the earth is, sorry, I have to block that sun out each time. So now the earth is all frozen. There we go. And the ground is solid. So, just to recap on yesterday's. Right, there we go. So we left that padding for a reason. We're gonna take it out later, but we had to dig much further than we thought because my garden is higher than everybody else's. The building was gonna stand too tall, so we've had to go further in. And because we're doing it by hand, sorry, I'm just gonna position myself. Goodness, that's behind the camera, behind us. Yeah, so we've got to dig a lot further. The gaps doesn't actually look that bad on video, but it's pretty deep, and doing it by hand, we moved a tremendous amount of dirt. But I'm gonna feather all this in. It'll all look good by the time I'm finished, but we actually just think of a quick and easy way to deal with it. So the end result will be good, but it's just a ton more work. So it slowed us right down, unfortunately. Now, because if you remember, I said the building was gonna start where there was a black line on this pad. It means I've lost about a foot in size for urban. So I'm either gonna have to cut this pad and take a foot of it out, or I'm gonna have to sacrifice a foot in urban. Short term, I'd sacrifice a foot by 14 foot, but long term, I think it's probably worth cutting the pad out. Now, I'm sorry if I sound a little bit ropey. Working in aquatic and reptile specialist shop for a long time, for 10 years, but because I'm the owner, this is pretty tough work, and it's kind of caught up with me a little bit. So me and Ben just absolutely went at it, just dug and dug and dug and dug, and I reckon we've done around 200 wheelbarrows, 100 each. It's been tough work. It'll be worth it, and I am enjoying it, but it's been a ton of work. So yeah, so for today, it looks like work's gonna stop. This ground is just too hard, so maybe if the sun stays out, you can see it's a beautiful sunny day. If the sun stays out, maybe I'll be able to continue in a couple of hours. But yeah, sorry, this part of the build is pretty straightforward and boring, but I did say I'll take you every step of the way, and that's what I'm doing. But it is a little bit boring. Once we start doing more of the woodwork and joinery, I'm gonna do more time lapses. It's just, I've done a time lapse or two of us digging, but there's only so much digging you'd obviously be interested in watching. So yeah, for now, that's all, guys, and I'll keep them coming. Cheers. I need you.
This my new shoe. I'm the black bitchy bitch with the roof missing. If it don't make dollars, don't make sense.